Dear friends, so a while ago, I proposed the idea with a lot of good response and feedback from all of you that the universe is a 3D printout and the cosmic computer is cosmic consciousness and it prints out a 3D movie in the theater of space-time and causality through digital mechanics, a digital workshop in cosmic consciousness. I found this idea resonating with a lot of you. So today I thought I'd actually expand on this idea and connect it to qualia science, quantum science, quantum biology, and a deeper understanding of the qualia field and the quantum field. So my theory is as follows. What we call the quantum field is imbued with subjectivity. I know that mainstream scientists will sneer at this, but never mind. The quantum field is actually a qualia field. We know the quantum field as a result of experience through modes of knowing and experience, which are qualia. So qualia are qualities of experience, and the fundamental matrix of creation is a consciousness field of infinite possibilities, without cause, spaceless, timeless, irreducible, fundamental, but it manifests as experience. When the experience is created by the consciousness field manifesting as a qualia field of conscious agents. So the field, the consciousness field, is known through experience, qualia. The measurement of that, or the modeling of that, is quantum fields. So quantum fields are a modeling of qualia fields. They're complementarities, in a sense. So one is experience, the qualia field is experience, and the quantum field is the modeling of that experience, the qualia field. So they're both connected, and everything that we call quantum biology and quantum consciousness is actually the modeling of the consciousness field manifesting as the qualia field. So the fluctuations of consciousness, which are also called vrittis in yoga, vrittis. Vrittis literally means fluctuations, vibrations. They're also called spanda. Spanda is vibration. In a sense, corresponding to one of the interpretations of quantum mechanics, which is string theory. Unidimensional strings vibrating. But these are symbolic representations of the vrittis, fluctuations of consciousness, vibrating as sensations, images, feelings, and thoughts. So quantum biology and quantum metabolism are the new models that relate to the quantum field in several key ways. Here is some science. Remember, science is a modeling of experience also. So number one, quantum oscillations in biological systems. Quantum metabolism proposes that cellular metabolic processes can be modeled as quantum oscillators. Oscillators, vibrations, fluctuations, vrittis. It's all the same. So once again, quantum metabolism proposes that cellular metabolic processes can be modeled as quantum oscillators similar to those in solid-state physics. These oscillations are thought to occur in cellular organelles like mitochondria, where enzymatic reactions exhibit quantum behavior. The quantum field provides the underlying framework for these oscillations. Fantastic, I love it. Okay. Number two, energy quantization in metabolism. So quantum metabolism suggests that metabolic energy is quantized with ATP molecules serving as biological energy quanta. This quantization is analogous to energy quantization in quantum fields. Number two. Number three, quantum coherence and superposition. Biological processes like photosynthesis and enzyme catalysis may exploit quantum coherence and superposition to achieve greater efficiency. These quantum effects arise from their interactions between biological molecules and the quantum field. Fascinating. I love it. Number four, quantum tunneling. Electron and proton tunneling, a quantum phenomenon, has been observed in enzyme reactions and may play a role in processes like olfaction. Olfaction is best studied by, I believe, all sensory processes, and also DNA mutations. Number five, entanglement in biological systems. Many researchers now propose that quantum entanglement may occur in biological systems, potentially influencing processes like animal navigation. Entanglement is a fundamental property of quantum fields. Number six, quantum criticality. Some biomolecules have evolved to exist in a state of quantum criticality, allowing them to behave between insulators and conductors. This property emerges from the interaction between matter and the quantum field. And number seven, open quantum systems. Biological systems are often described as open quantum systems, constantly exchanging energy with their environment. This interaction between the system and its environment, which is the extended body, in my opinion, is needed to fully understand the role of quantum effects in biological systems. Okay, so much for that. Now, as a practical example, and I've shared this with you before, I once in my practice was looking at the chart of a patient when the patient was in front of me, and very hesitantly and reluctantly, I informed him that he might have cancer. And as soon as I uttered those words, the word cancer, you may have cancer, I could see a shift in his biology. First in his body language, his facial expressions, and the tone of his voice, the contracted state of his body posture. And if I had measured his blood pressure, it would have been up. If measured his heart rate, it would have been up. Measured the heart rate variability, it would have been down. Measured the state of inflammation in his body, it would have been up. But as soon as I gave him this information, I suddenly realized that I was reading the wrong chart, and I really profusely apologized to him and said, "I'm so sorry. That wasn't your chart. Actually, you're very healthy." And immediately everything shifted. His biological state shifted. So suddenly he was smiling, his posture was more relaxed, and everything changed. Facial expressions, tone of voice, blood pressure, heart rate variability, level of enzymes. So what was this? This was a shift in consciousness that instantly caused a shift in biology. Shift in consciousness, and everything changed, not just one thing. Okay. His thoughts changed, his facial expression changed, his eye movements changed, his body language changed, his tone of voice changed, and his biological parameters all changed instantly. A shift in consciousness caused a shift in biology, and the shifts were based on what we might today call first a nocebo response. Nocebo comes from the Latin word. Nocebo is the Latin word. I shall displease. The information displeased him. And then immediately followed by a placebo effect, a Latin word, I shall please. And just that one piece of information caused a shift in biology, because there was a shift in consciousness, and everything at all times prior to this remained in superposition. And ideally, that superposition manifests as homeostasis, normal homeostasis. But euphoria, which is actually super homeostasis, is also, in a sense, a state of consciousness that creates ecstasy in the mind and ecstasy in the body at the same time. So these are the correlations between quantum biology, quantum consciousness, quantum metabolism, quantum fields, qualia fields, and consciousness fields. I hope this information is helpful to you. And remember, we can continue this conversation with my digital twin, digitaldeepak.ai. And remember, the digital dharma will guide you on how to use AI to improve personal well-being and also elevate spiritual intelligence. Take care and God bless.